Hi, I'm Jacob with AltaPoint Data Systems, the makers of the Health Builder and AltaPoint practice management softwares. In today's video, we're going to be talking about ePrescribe powered by MD Toolbox and how to actually write, send, and refill prescriptions for your patients. Let's get to it. This lower section is the patient medication section of the ePrescribe screen. Here you can view medications that have already been entered, write a new prescription, or complete prescriptions that haven't been finalized yet. I'm going to click on the new Rx button to bring up our prescription writing screen. Now, before I get into writing this prescription, I want to point out the new order as well as the historical radio buttons here on the side. By clicking the historical button, we can enter information without writing a new prescription for the patient. So we can put in a date that was prescribed. We can select whether that's a current medication, a historical medication, or discontinued. And we can tell the system who it was prescribed by as well. If that's someone from our practice, we can just click on the drop-down menu and select that. If you don't know any other details other than the drug name, you can also click this box. So let's start writing a prescription. I'm going to search for a penicillin, and before I do that, I'm just going to point out again that I have that amoxicillin allergy there, as well as some other drugs that we've written before already in the system. Now you can see here that there's a check mark for the things that are on a formulary that aren't preferred. You've got the star with the one that's the preferred level one. If you want to see the information on the drug reference, you can click that here. There's also a similar icon up here for when you've got that drug selected later on. And I'm just going to choose a tablet because I like the tablets. And here's our first interaction warning. Obviously, we can cancel and search again. We don't want to make a patient sick. But if there is a reason to continue an override, we can do that and write the reason for that override here. If you want to see that drug interaction again, you can have it searched manually by clicking on this heart. If you're not finding the drug that you're looking for, we can come to the drug search tools, this drop-down menu, and select the kind of drugs we're looking for. Maybe you want a supply rather than all drugs or something from a favorites list. All drugs will bring up all. If you're searching with begins with, like I did with penicillin, you can start out writing penicillin. If it's something more along the lines of like a dextroamphetamine, for example, if you were to start writing amphetamine, it's probably going to miss that because it doesn't start with it. So you could select contains and that would catch that anywhere in there. If you needed a brand only or a generic only, you could search that way. Obsolete, if you wanted to do that. Common directions, favorite directions, those we'll be entering later. And then the save to favorites. So if you write a prescription for penicillin frequently, for example, and want the same dosage, the same frequency, and all of that information, you can save that to the favorites list and not have to rewrite that every time. Now the nice thing is you can save that prescription for the prescriber themselves, or you can save that for all of the prescribers, and that way you don't have people writing the same prescriptions over and over again. Now let's say that the formulary isn't what we want. I'm going to go ahead and change this because this one has a mail order, for example, and I don't want that. So I'll change that. It'll find the formulary information if there is any and enter that here. We have our little dosage check down here, kind of give you a dosage range if you want. You don't necessarily need that per day, per dose. You can close that if that's in the way. For our directions, we can enter our directions manually here if we want. One tablet, for example, 1 to 2 times a day, 2 times a day. If you know the shorthand, that can be entered as well. I'm just going to select that. You can also enter that down below where it has a little more laid out way, one dose, tablet, we want that orally, for example, times 2 per day, 2 total in the day, if we want to do it after meals, before meals, whatever that may be. So that's an option. If you want to clear that or if you want to hide that, you can either click that or the little open close here. If you needed to do 1 in the morning or 2 at night, you could enter that up here as well, you know, any of those directions that you need. Of course, we'll tell it how many tablets to dispense and how many days, number of refills, substitutions or as written, And then if you need to write a note for the pharmacy, of course, that can be entered here. This is only for the pharmacy. It won't be seen by the patient. Diagnosis and ICD, you really don't need to worry about with an AltaPoint Health Builder. This is more for other systems or people who use the MD toolbox you prescribe all by itself. Internal notes, and then auto-expire or auto-renew. If you write something that's going to be renewed, you can select auto-renew, and that way the pharmacy can renew that for the patient. If auto-expire, then they have to get a hold of you to renew that or to be seen again or whatever the case may be in your situation. At the top, we have these buttons to finish off our prescription writing. So we can send and save now, which of course will save the prescription and we'll send it off to the pharmacy or select the pharmacy in this case since we don't have one. We can save it and it just will sit here on the screen. Save and new allows us to write a new prescription as well. So we will be writing multiple prescriptions for this patient. The save and new button allows us to write another prescription. So if we wanted to write multiple prescriptions for the same patient and send it all at once, we can do that. Or we can click save and close, and that'll close our screen here. Take us back to the main prescription page. If you already have a prescription saved to your favorites list with all of its details, simply come to this pull-down menu to add a prescription of your choice. Now let's take a look at dealing with some of these pending medications that have been written but haven't been finalized. So if I were to look here and see that something's wrong, or if I wanted to see the details of that prescription, I can click on the open Rx detail icons or on the medication name and information links here. Now I've got a pending and a pending approved, because I've got this approved. You can either click on the approved or you can click on the way you want to deal with it to approve. And in choosing that, you can choose to send it electronically, you can choose to print it, or you can choose to mark it complete, which will add it to the current medications list, but not send it anywhere. It won't go electronically, it won't be printed, won't be faxed, won't go by carrier pigeon. So whatever you want to do with that. Just to be a little different, show you a little variety, I'm going to go ahead and click on print. Of course, if you don't need a prescription anymore for one reason or another, need to take it off the list, you can always delete or remove that. So I'm going to go ahead and click on complete. And that brings up our preview prescription. So you see different tabs here for the eSend for the print preview. Here on the eSend, we can choose the pharmacy we want it to go to and search it. If you've already got that saved previously, that'll show up here as well. We've got all our information. You can choose to eSend the prescriptions that are going electronically. You can choose to print those that are being printed, or you can choose both. If you need to print, you can come into this print format and choose the different kinds of prescription paper you want to use. With the printing, you also have the option to either print and hand it to the patient, or of course fax it in yourself. If the prescription is being written for a controlled substance and the prescriber hasn't signed up for two-factor authentication credentials, or hasn't been granted access to use it, the system will default that drug to print and the eSend will be disabled. I would still highly recommend using the ePrescribe to write those prescriptions rather than, say, writing it out for the patient, because you've got the drug interaction check as well as SureScripts having a history so that they can help prevent fraud. If the prescriber has been issued a valid two-factor authentication credential and granted access in the access control screen, the system will allow that eSend. Sending a controlled substance with eSend really isn't all that different from sending a non-controlled drug. Of course, you do want to check and make sure that the pharmacy can receive the controlled substances, so they've got the EPCS label next to the pharmacy. And then when you click eSend, as you normally would, any non-controlled substances will be sent first, and you'll get a message saying that those were sent. Of course, if there aren't any, you won't get that message. So now the controlled substance sign-off screen will open, and the prescriber can enter their password as well as the VIP security code from the second-factor authenticator. So if they're using the software token, you enter the security code from the app installed on the phone, or if the hardware token, you use the key fob device, push the button, and generate the security code. Once either of those are entered, you click on the sign and send button, and you'll then receive the notification message that that prescription has been sent. Of course, with a patient's medication list, you're not just looking to see what's been written and what needs to be dealt with. You're also looking to see what's current, what's historical, or what's been discontinued. And of course, like anything in here, if one of these statuses need to be changed, we can come over and do that with these icons. I'm going to kind of take this from a green means go to a red means stop sort of an order. So of course, with the green full button, we add that as a pending medication, so that gets ready to go. We can mark a medication current again. If we need to mark a medication as historical, we can do that with this little negative don't come this way sign. And of course, the red stop hand means it's been discontinued. Another nice feature with the Z-Prescribe is that if I'm finished with this patient and have some other pending medications to look at, I don't have to go out, find our patient in AltaPoint or Health Biller, come back into the prescribe and deal with it that way to make sure we have the right patient. We can click on the show menu, and under this pending RX option, we have a list of those pending prescriptions. So I'm going to go ahead and just click on David Cross, and it takes us straight here with his pending medication. The last thing that I want to point out briefly is something you may have already noticed as we've been going back and forth through the system, and that's where the pharmacy refill requests are. So I'm going to come back over to this show menu, and we have our tab for the pharmacy refill requests. Now here you'll be shown how many refill requests are currently waiting in the system, but as of course my demo data doesn't have any pharmacies sending refill requests, I don't have any to show you specifically. You can also click here to see some of the details on these refill requests. Thanks for watching this video. For more tips and tricks on using your AltaPoint or Health Biller practice management system to more effectively run your practice, click on the subscribe button and click the bell notification to know when more of these videos are released. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.